Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today in this video I am going to show you how to install Next.js and then how to create your first Next.js app. So I am going to create a Hello World Next.js project and I am going to show you how to run that on our browser. So I am going to edit the file and I am going to show you all the changes on our browser. So this video is going to be really informative. So if you are into web development, if you want to learn about Next.js, and if you want to start our Next.js journey, so then this video is totally for you. So do watch the video till the end. If you like the video, please give it a like, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. That would really motivate me to make more such videos. Now to install and create Next.js, first thing that you need to have is two software. One is Visual Studio Code, and then you need to have Node.js. So you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and you need to type over here Node.js download and hit enter, and you'll be able to see this Node.js as our link. So just simply open that. Immediately you'll be able to land over to the official site of Node.js. So this link I'm going to put right in our description, so you can directly use that link to land over the official site of Node.js. And here you can see we have two options, one is LTS one, another is the current one, right? So I'm going to recommend you to install LTS one, alright? So LTS version at the time of making this video is version 20.11.0, and it also includes NPM, so NPM version is version 10.2.4, alright? So depending upon what operating system you are using, Windows, macOS or any other, you need to select that operating system. I'm going to select Windows. And you can see it is properly started downloading our Node.js. Right, I have already downloaded it, so I'll minimize this. I'll go to my download directory, and you can see that our Node.js is rightly over here. So let's double click on our Node.js to install it locally on our system. So here you need to click on install anyway, and you can see welcome to Node.js setup wizard. So just simply click on next. So this is our license agreement. You can always read this. Click on I accept, click on next. So this is our node destination folder, so you can keep this default. Click on next. So these are all files it's going to be installed. Also it's going to add our path to environment variable, so that's a very important step. So that is what it automatically going to do. So it is totally fine, just simply keep everything as a default. Click on next, and it is asking whether you'd like to install Chocolaty. I don't want to install Chocolaty for now, so I'll keep all the things as a default. Click on next. So ready to be installed, click on install, and there you go. It will ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes, and our installation is rightly begun. So by the time our Node.js get installed, I'll download our Visual Studio Code. So just simply open a new tab and just simply type Visual Studio Code, and let's click on this Visual Studio Code, and it's going to redirect to the official site of Visual Studio Code. So again, this link I'm going to put right in our description. So you need to click on this download for Windows, and you can see it immediately started downloading our Visual Studio Code over here. It just rightly started, right? So if you can go to our Node.js, you can see it is properly installed now. You can click on finish. So our Node.js is successfully installed, and our Visual Studio Code is, you know, downloaded over here. So just, you know, simply click on that link to install Visual Studio Code, and here click on install anyway. And this is our Visual Studio Code installation, you know, license agreement. Now to accept this, click on next. So this is where our Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. Totally fine. Click on next, and it's going to create Visual Studio Code start menu folder. Again, totally fine. Click on next, and it is also asking whether you like to create a desktop shortcut icon. Again, fine. Also check this open with code and click on next. So click on install. And it is preparing to install, and it's going to install it locally on our system. So let's minimize our browser and our download directory as well. So you can see our Visual Studio rightly started installing, and you can see that our Visual Studio is rightly installed. So also launch Visual Studio Code option is enabled. So just, you know, simply click on finish over here to launch our Visual Studio Code, and you can see our Visual Studio Code is rightly launched. So I'll close this. I'm going to, you know, create a Next.js app, right? So for that you need to first create a folder on our desktop. So just simply right click, create a new folder, and I'm going to give the folder name as Next.js, and I'm going to go inside that folder. And here what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this address bar, and I'm going to type cmd. and you can see that our command prompt is rightly open at this folder location. So here, to create our Next.js app, you need to just simply type this command called npx and then create, and then give a dash, then next-app, and then your app name. So I'm going to give the app name as my app. So basically npx, then create next app, then my app, hit enter. And you can see it is telling need to install the following packages. So just simply type y and hit enter. And you can see it is now asking that whether you'd like to use TypeScript. Again, yes. You can use, you know, pastebar to switch to yes or no, right? And again, ESLint, I am going to hit yes. Then Tailwind CSS, again, I am going to hit yes. Then you like to use src directory, yes. So I'm going to switch to yes. And whether you'd like to use app router, so you know, if you want to deep dive into router, then I'm going to definitely make a video. I'm going to make this video very simple, so I'm going to choose no, right? And now it is asking whether you'd like to customize the default import alias. So again, I'm not going to discuss much about that, so I'll just simply give no. And you can see it is, you know, rightly started creating our Next.js app. So what it's going to install is our React DOM next, and then all the dependencies are TypeScript, you know, and then Tailwind CSS, ESLint, all of that. You can see it is properly fetching all the files and installing it locally on our system, right? So you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation, and this will take some time, you know, about a couple of minutes I would say. So once you are done with this, I'm going to again back to this video. Yep, so we'll come back, and now you can clearly see success. So our Next.js app is rightly installed and rightly created. So here, if you see our folder Next.js, we have created my app, right? So you know, go to our command prompt and just simply type cd and give your project name, which is my app. So we are going to go inside our my app, and we are now currently inside our my app. Now just simply type code dot, hit enter. So what it will do is it will going to open our this folder my app in our Visual Studio Code. So you can click on this I trust the authors. So you can see our my app project is rightly opened over here. So this is our Next.js app. So if you expand our src folder, you can see we have two folders again, pages, then styles. If we expand pages, you can see we have all these files. So our index.tsx file is our, you know, file that going to be rendered on our browser. And you can also expand our style, so which contains global.css. So again, this is using Tailwind. You can see, you can click on this package.json. So you can see it is using React 18, and it is, you know, our Next.js version 14 app, right? So everything is fine. You need to click on this triple dot to enable our npm scripts. So once you have that enabled, I mean checked, you'll be able to see npm scripts over here. So if you expand this, you'll be seeing this dev. So just, you know, simply click on this run button, and immediately you can see it is rightly started executing, right? So it's going to build our project and going to run it on our browser. You can see it is rightly builded, and this is our, you know, local host 300. So if you click on this and click on this follow link, it will going to show you our Next.js project on our browser. So you can see our Next.js is rightly launched over here, right? So if you go to again your Visual Studio Code, and let's, you know, change something. So let's go to index.tsx file, and here you can see you have a lot many things, right? So within our main tag, what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove all these things, you know, till our end of our main tag. So I'm going to remove all of that, and I'm going to give, you know, h1 tag. And within our h1 tag, I'm going to write hello Geeky Script, right? So now if you just simply save this file, immediately you can see it is rightly started compiling. And once that compilation get completed, you can go to our browser. You can see it is properly rendered on that same local host, and you can see the output hello Geeky Script is showing, right? So in this way, you can easily install our Next.js app within Windows operating system. So I have showed you how to install Visual Studio Code, then Node.js, and then how to install our Next.js app, right? So that's basically all about this video. I have started Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I am posting coding related videos. So please do subscribe this channel. That really motivate me to make more such videos. And I have also started a Geeky Script blogging channel. So again, if you're interested, you can also subscribe on my blogging channel as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.